Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Project Podcast. My name is Ira Bowman. I'm your host. And today I'm excited. I have Mary McLendon here, who is a leadership success coach, and she's the founder of Learn, Live, Be. Welcome to the show, Mary.
Thanks, Ira. I'm so excited to be here.
I'm happy to have you here, too. I'm excited to talk about your program. I'm also excited to talk about something I think a lot of our clients, a lot of people that I'm helping with are struggling with. So we're going to jump into it. I have three questions for you today. Should take about 10 minutes in total. So if you're ready, I'm going to start with the first question.
Shoot.
All right, here we go. Do you feel part of the issue people are having getting a job these days is due to their desire to climb the ladder in as part of their job change, and they're getting weeded out by the ATS, the applicant tracking system?
Yeah, I think that's really a two-part challenge, right? You know, the application tracking system can be a challenge if you haven't done your due diligence. But, you know, moving out of one role into another and promoting yourself, you know, getting to that next level can be a challenge. And I think my advice would be for people who are doing that is to expand their thought process on what leadership is. I think sometimes people think they need to have a formal, you know, manager, team leader, supervisor kind of title in order to move ahead in a particular role. When in fact, in your life, you do a lot of leading, whether it's with your church or it's special projects for fundraisers, or maybe you're part of a board or you've done some special projects with other people. Those skills are transferable. You don't necessarily have to fundamentally have, you know, higher fire authority over a group of people.
You're fired from my church board. Awesome. Okay. So yeah, I get that. I think that's something a lot of people are struggling with. It seems to be that, you know, changing jobs in the past was seen as an opportunity to climb the ladder. And sure, you still can, like you said, you just have to pull in some of that experience, maybe not from a job, but from, you know, some other source, volunteering or whatever, so that right, they can see that you're qualified. The other thing you and I talked about off camera, which I'd like to bring into that, is making sure that you read those job descriptions really well. And if they're asking for things or you're using phrases in the job description, you want to make sure you put that in your resume so that that ATS system picks it out. Because basically what the ATS does more than anything is it pre-screens you from being seen by a human being. You can explain why you have something in, but if it's not there, you won't ever be interviewed. So
yeah,
you want to make
correct,
people are clear about that.
Yeah, there's a shift that has happened with resumes. You know, in the past, they used to be historical documents. Let me tell you where I've been, what I've done, what I've accomplished. And now they're really more marketing documents.
Absolutely.
And so finding alignment with a specific job description absolutely means you need to call out of your experience what applies to their requirements and make sure you're using their language and nomenclature in order to get picked out.
Man, I couldn't say it any better. In fact, honestly, I have a question that I might have to rewrite now because I actually phrased it just the way you said it. The resume used to be seen as a historical document and now it's seen as a marketing piece. And it's more about now what you can do moving forward than what you did previously. Cool. What Absolutely. You did previously is important, but they're only interested in that because they want to know what you can do for them now, right?
Moving
forward. Awesome answer. I think hopefully people will sink their teeth into that and it'll help them with their strategy moving forward. But next question, which is also another thing I think people are struggling with, or maybe not doing at all, but what advice would you give to job seekers in regard to networking in person so they can increase the likelihood of getting hired?
That's a great question, Ira. I mean, at the end of the day, a person hires you, not an ATS or anything else, right? And so connecting with people is really important. Your network is the single most important asset that you have when you're job seeking. And I would recommend you keep it warm even when you're not.
Absolutely.
You know, amazingly, 80% of jobs are not posted and are actually filled through people's networks.
Yeah.
And, you know, one of the things that I have found that is super helpful. There's a function in LinkedIn called career advice. Mm-hmm. And you can actually sign up to be somebody who gives advice, which is what I am, or you can reach out to people and receive advice.
Yeah.
You'd be amazed at how many people I actually connect back with who don't actually take advantage of that situation, you know, to engage with me. Because once, you know, the phrase 6 degrees of separation,
right?
So my network on its surface may not look like it's valuable to somebody, but networking with me immediately opens up my network to them.
Well, it connects them from you to me.
Correct.
I have 30,000 people in my network. So if you don't like me, you might like some of the 30,000 people that I've got in mind. There's no doubt about it.
And what's amazing about keeping a network warm and being able to work with people is people really do want to help. And you ask for help, genuine help, whether it is, hey, take a look at my resume. I'm trying to find a job. I'll use my history and background in business operations. Can you tell me what I need to do to improve my opportunity to fit a job like that?
Yeah.
That's the same thing as asking to help you find a job, but also doing it in a way that you're seeking help and advice, and people love to give advice and connecting. And now all of a sudden you've got somebody who's willing to pass you on because now you've been able to pitch yourself to them kind of on the side, right?
Yeah.
You've asked for help, but at the same time asked for the resume to be passed on into the network. It's really a subtle way of saying, hey, can you help me find a job?
There's no doubt. And I think you touched on something super important. So I want to just back up and highlight that. Most people are key on networking when they're looking for a job, but not as much when they're not. And it should be the opposite, because if you can build those relationships when you're not looking for anything in particular, you know, you're not asking them for help right out of the gate. You're just trying to be the friends and make connections. People are more apt to help you when you're not desperate. Also, mm-hmm. you don't come across as being self-centered or selfish. You come across as more genuine. So for example, if I'm going to reach out to somebody who maybe is a director of sales or a vice president of sales and talk to them and say, hey, you know, what did you do to get that job? And, you know, can you look at my background and get to know me a little bit and give me advice on things that I could do to prepare myself for down the road when I might be, you know, ready to try to make that jump and get them to give you mentorship that way. But you're not, you know, saying, hey, can you talk to your HR person and get me hired? Or can you recommend me to a recruiter, to this person, or that person? You're just genuinely there to pick their brain. You allow them to talk about themselves, for them to be the expert. And man, it's amazing what people will open up and give you when it's from that perspective. It's not from, hey, I'm starving to death. I've got 4 kids. I've got 8 kids, but you know, I've got so many kids that I need to feed them. I get those types of requests all the time. It's sheer desperation. It's like almost overwhelming. And I want to throw my hands up and go, whoa, we need to slow down. But if someone comes at me gradually, you know, I get to know them a little bit through the posts. And then they say, hey, you know, I noticed that you were a sales manager for a large print company. And I would love to be, you know, a sales manager for a large print company. Can you help me figure out how you got that job and, you know, what things helped you along the way? Now it's a much different conversation. So
absolutely. I mean, here's the thing, Ira, the bottom line is if I pass you on, you're now standing on my credibility and success.
Yeah.
So the more you make it easier for me to get to know you so I can stand for you, the more likely I am to pass you through my network.
Yeah. And you know, the more friendly it is, as opposed to, you know, you're just scratching my back, you know, and I'm moving on, you know, after I use you for what you're worth. It's like, no, we're going to be, you know, friends. And that is much more valuable. You're going to get, you know, recommendations, and you're going to get better advice. And, you know, they're going to be thinking about you to talk to people, as opposed to just maybe sharing your resume one time or, you know, commenting on a post. Anyways, I want to move on because we're running short on time, and I want to get to this last question, which is about your Learn, Live, Be. So can you tell our audience a little bit more about Learn, Live, Be, who the target clients are, and how you help make better use of their time?
Sure. So we use a combination of coaching, mentoring, and consulting to help our clients be better at what they do and move through our change process called Making It Real.
Okay.
And we help clients, organizations, and teams do that. Right now we're focused on work-life balance. And I know a lot of people think that's a myth, but I spent a lot of time in corporate life and managed to have balance.
That's
and so
good.
I'm passing on that learning to others and releasing in a beta mode this week a Win Back Your Week masterclass. Okay. And since it's in a beta mode, I'm offering some real approachable pricing. It's 9 weeks of one-on-one coaching with me for $297.
Wow.
And so it's, you know, usually valued at $3,600, but I wanted to make it very approachable so that A, I could help a bunch of people, and B, I could learn to improve my process through helping others. And so it's a back and forth. So
I'm really good at math.
Okay.
So 9 weeks, $3,600, that would be $400 a week. And you're giving the whole program away for less than 1 week's worth of actual pay. That's exactly amazing. That's an amazing value.
Yeah. And your tribe is the first one I'm offering it to.
Awesome. So now, do they need to say anything to you? Like, hey, I'm part of Project Topi Grow, or?
No, they don't. Actually, I have a countdown on my website for when the enrollment closes. I haven't really actually published it to anybody else except your tribe first.
Okay.
And it's at www.learnlivebe.com. Pretty straightforward. And awesome. Gives a whole background, gives you an opportunity to apply, right? It's an application process because I have a limited number of seats.
Sure.
You reserve your seat for $47, which is fully refundable if you don't get a seat. And then we would start the process once that application is received and you're secured a seat, and we go from there.
Okay. Well, what I'm going to do for sure is I'm going to, if anybody's watching this on my website, right, if you're not on YouTube or one of the other mm-hmm. social media platforms, but if you're on Project Help You Grow, if you click on the body of the description of this podcast, then it'll take you straight to your website. I'm going to make that an active hyperlink. Okay. And if not, it should be in the description, wherever you're watching this, live, learn, live, be, and find Mary that way. Mary, I want to thank you so much for coming on. It's been awesome to have you. I'm looking forward to, you've already agreed to come back. So I'm looking forward to that. And I hope that people are smart enough to take you up on this class. Time management is something that most people struggle with, and having a professional and a personal life balance is critical to sustaining a long, happy life for both. It's important for your employer. It's important for your family. It's important for your well-being. So I hope people will take advantage of it. And I look forward to having you on again real soon.
Thank you so much for the opportunity. I really appreciate it.
It's been my pleasure. Have a great day.
You too.